Hello everyone, welcome back to UX Design DGM 153. Today, or at least in this presentation, we're going to be talking about drawing flowcharts in Adobe Illustrator CC for 2018. So if it's like 2020, you may want to skip this and go to something more recent. The supplies you're going to need for this tutorial are Adobe Creative Cloud membership, which is kind of expensive. So if you don't already own it, switch to another method in the assignments. I have lots and lots of really, really easy ways to draw flowcharts listed, and this is not necessary. If you happen to be a design student and you already own the Adobe Creative Cloud membership, which means you're paying for it already, you should have some experience with Illustrator. So feel free to use this to kind of look at how to draw flowcharts in Illustrator. I'm going to be using some instances and stamps to speed up my workflow, and so it's a little bit more of an advanced tutorial. But as all of my tutorials, we're going to start by looking at the scenario. Okay, so just to refresh your memory, the scenario for the app that I will be making is going to be different than the one you're making for the assignment. But it's an app that allows people to exchange pet food recipes so they can cook a meal for Fido. The app name is called Made with Love. It will have a login page, a recipe input page, a finished recipe page, some sort of search recipe page, and somewhere where it displays a list of recipes, recipes by species, and ingredients. So that's the idea. Now, there are advantages and disadvantages to using Illustrator. The advantage for Illustrator is that it's incredibly powerful. So you can make stunning, gorgeous, extra shiny flowcharts and pretty much anything else. It has an undo option. In fact, you can undo all the way to the beginning of your document if you mess up. It also has spell check, which I love. And it lets you make display boards that are as big as you need them to be. So if your flowchart needs to be as large as a highway advertising board, billboard, you can do that. Now, it also has several built-in arrows and types of image styles that you can utilize for your flowchart to make it shiny and special, but it does have some disadvantages. First of all, it's pretty expensive. On its own, Illustrator, Adobe's subscription is $19.99. If you're a student, you can buy the entire Adobe Creative Cloud subscription, which is on a monthly basis, for about $29 to $20, depending on the sale that they're having. And that's with your school ID and proof that you are a student. Okay? So if you don't already own this, once again, don't go buying Illustrator. Figma is just as good. You can use Word to create really great flowcharts. But if you happen to be a design student and you already own this or have access to it, go for it. Illustrator does take time to learn. It has a lot of bells and whistles, and so it's a massive software. And that makes it frustrating if you are using it for the first time, which once again, if you don't already own it, don't invest in this. Use sticky notes, pen and paper, go to Figma, use Word. Okay. It also has a massive interface that changes frequently. Every 2 years or so, Illustrator does an update, and sometimes some of the menu items move. So you have to stay on top of it, which is, if you're not going to use it in the future, don't feel the need to invest in it. Okay? Where to start? Got to figure out, once again, what are the needs of the app? What is the first screen going to be? What device you will be designing for? You're going to pick a starting point. Traditionally, the upper left-hand corner works. And draw the first screen the viewer will see. Then, when you are done with all of it, you're going to save the whole thing as a PDF so that everyone can view it. Okay? Your equipment for this mission is going to be a computer. You're going to need an internet connection, Adobe Creative Cloud subscription installed on your, and the software installed on your computer. So, keep that in mind. If you don't already own it, don't use it. Okay, so here we go. As you can see, I've already started Illustrator in my desk on my desktop. I'm working on a PC right now, which means that if you have a Mac at home, the main differences are going to be keyboard shortcuts, which I'm going to avoid using for this tutorial just for that reason. The rest of the software looks and feels pretty much the same. So here we go. Once Illustrator starts, And if you've used it before, you will notice that you have the option to create a new file or start something that's recent. You can also go to the drop-down file menu and create something new. You can see there it says new. Ooh. Now I'm going to hit the Create New button, and I'm going to select a regular letter size paper. Default, we can always make it bigger. Okay, now once I have that selected, I'm going to hit the Create button and hope that my computer doesn't crash because I'm screen capturing a very, very powerful piece of software. Okay, I'm going to expand my view so it takes up the full screen, and we have our main sheet of paper. Now, the tools that we're going to need for this specific tutorial are your color mixing palette, your swatches. I'm also going to use the paintbrushes palette and its library. So I'm going to just click on that and select arrows so we can look at all the fun and crazy arrows we're going to be able to use. And I'm going to get the shapes library because they also have a whole bunch of options. Things like buttons, 3D symbols, charts, for example. Okay, so I'm going to use the charts options for this one. Now, you can draw everything out by hand. That is not a problem whatsoever. You can also flip through all the different possibilities for icons, backgrounds, styles, crazy flower looking things, and you can create brand new shapes on your own as well using the drawing tools. But for the purposes of this presentation, we're going to use some pre-built options. Out of this library, because I'm just working on organizational charts, just trying to put our thoughts together, I'm going to use the instances of rectangles. And the way you do that is you click on the selection tool at the upper right-hand corner, you grab one of the shapes and drag it onto the pasteboard by clicking on the shape and dragging it down. Ta-da! There it is. So my first shape I know is going to be my loading screen. Okay. I can move it around by clicking on it. It is an instance of the symbol, which means that it has been created, it lives somewhere in the library, and if I wanted to mess with it, I would have to either break with the original symbol or edit the symbol itself, which is right here, edit symbol. Okay, and that will change all of the drawn symbols. So that's one. The other option that you can have, if you don't like the shapes that we're working with, because say we want to work with a shape for Photoshop or for a cell phone, something different, you can click on the Rectangles tool and then click and drag a rectangle that fits your needs more. So if we're working with a cell phone, for example, I can work with a rectangle that looks kind of like this. Once I have one rectangle, I switch to the selection tool at the top, and then I can click and drag an instance of this rectangle to my symbols palette, which gives me a brand new symbol. So I'm going to call this layout, and I'm going to hit OK. Now this cool symbol in the symbols palette can be just dragged over and over on the page, which saves me a lot of time. Now, I'm not quite done with this yet. I want to style it a little bit. I'm going to start with this rectangle by drawing a rectangle, upper right-hand corner. That's kind of foam-shaped. I'm not being too particular about it. I'm going to change the outline to say purple for fun. And the background, I'm going to change to a light gray so that it pops out of the background a little bit more, but doesn't mess with my typography when I'm working on the type. Okay, there's my first rectangle. If I want to get extra funky, you can see these little circles in the corners, the blue circles. If you click and drag them, you start rounding the corners. So if you really want to make it kind of look like a phone screen, there it is, rounded corners for a phone. There it is. Okay. So I have my basic layout symbol. Once I have this, I'm going to drag it into my symbols palette to create a new symbol. I'm going to say phone and save it, which means that for every other screen, I just drag this on here. Okay, to add type, I'm going to click on the type tool. It looks like the letter T and it shows up in your toolbox, usually on the left-hand side of the page. Once you click on it, you can click and drag a box. And you'll notice that Illustrator fills it with lorem ipsum. It's just filler text. So in this box, I'm going to just very quickly write down what this is. This is a loading screen for Made with Love. Logo will appear. I've got this text box. To move it, I click the selection tool once again, and I move it on top of my regular drawing, my start page. Cool. Okay. Next page. This is going to be our login screen, because remember from the PowerPoint that you just saw, we need a login screen. So once again, I grab my type tool. I click and drag a box that's about the width of that of the rectangle we've made, and I type in login screen. I hit return a couple times to give myself some space, and then I write down create new. We need a username. Password. Or log in with Facebook. Gmail. And then finally submit.